Welcome to our senior project documentary. I'm Dan Radell.
I'm Robbie Hansen.
And I'm Brian Parra.
Over the next 2 weeks, we're going to be researching all the documents and evidence surrounding Michael Behenna's case.
We'll be making posters and flyers to spread the awareness of this case during these next 2 weeks and in the future as well.
I hope you enjoy. Thank you. Up and at 'em bright and early,
I'm all business in my suit. Yeah, defend Michael.
Defend Michael.
Defend Michael. I don't do it for the money. There's bills that I can't pay. I don't do it for the glory. I just do it anyway. Providing for our futures. My responsibility. Yeah, I'm real good. This is the story of First Lieutenant Michael Behenna's case. Michael was accused by the United States of killing Ali Mansour, a known al-Qaeda operative. In 2008, First Lieutenant Behenna receives a phone call from a man named Ali threatening him that if his platoon goes to Abu Toma, that they will be harmed in the future. First Lieutenant Behenna's platoon follows their orders to check out Abu Toma. First Lieutenant Behenna is later told by Iraqis who he befriended that Ali Mansour's name is connected to the planning of an attack on his platoon. Weeks later, First Lieutenant Behenna's platoon is attacked through the use of an improvised explosive device, or IED, believed to be from al-Qaeda. The attack killed two American soldiers by the names of Stephen Christofferson and Adam Colas, and wounded two more. First Lieutenant Behenna's platoon is then instructed to detain Ali Mansour, a known al-Qaeda operative and weapons transporter. After failing to get any information from Mansour about the IED attack, Army intelligence follows its catch and release policy, which outlines that unless there is photographic evidence of a suspect at the scene of the attack, he cannot be held for a long time. Soldiers explain that it seems like they keep detaining and releasing the same terrorists due to this policy. To put this in perspective, and I quote, of the 87,011 detainees captured during the Iraq War, 76,985 were released. That's from Borkowski 1.
First Lieutenant Behenna is then ordered to return Mansour to his home. First of all, the United States Army should have not ordered Michael to return Mansour to his home because he was too personally involved in the attack. For example, when a police officer's partner is killed, that officer is removed completely from the investigation. First Lieutenant Behenna should have been granted the same form of leave, but he was not. Before First Lieutenant Behenna left, he told Mansour that he would be interrogating him later that day. First Lieutenant Behenna moved away from his platoon with the translator that he brought with him. During the interrogation, Mansour was playing dumb and not giving First Lieutenant Behenna any information. Behenna then pulled out his gun and questioned Mansour at gunpoint as a scare tactic. Mansour then said something in Arabic that First Lieutenant Behenna did not understand, so he turned to his translator, standing roughly 30 feet away, not wanting to get in the way of First Lieutenant Behenna. At this time, Mansour threw a piece of concrete at Behenna and launched at him. In self-defense, First Lieutenant Behenna shot Mansour dead.
Michael's claim of self-defense is supported by a prosecution expert witness, Dr. Herbert McDonald, who told the prosecution that Michael's story of self-defense was the only logical explanation. The prosecution then sent Dr. McDonald home so that he would not testify, ruining the prosecution's case. The prosecution never told the defense team that they had exculpatory evidence, which goes against the Supreme Court ruling of Brady v. Maryland. The controversy of this case is whether or not a soldier has the right to self-defense after initiating the incident. As of right now, if it is deemed the soldier initiated actions, he loses his right to self-defense. We believe that a soldier should never lose the right to self-defense under any circumstances. First Lieutenant Michael Behenna is serving a 25-year sentence in Fort Leavenworth that has been reduced to 15 years. Please go to www.defendmichael.com and click the link to sign the petition requesting a new trial for First Lieutenant Behenna. First Lieutenant Behenna is not a murderer. He is a decorated Army Ranger who has stellar reviews from his commanding officers and was recommended for promotion to captain. He is a brave leader and a diligent worker who was concerned for the lives of his soldiers. As written on the website, he fought for you. Now please fight for him. Thank you.
So Robbie, what do you plan on doing to help the situation?
So we are going to hang up big posters in a few different spots around Worcester, and we also made flyers that we're going to go hand out in Boston.
All right, Robbie, what are you doing right now?
All right, I'm making an outline for a poster, so we're going to put Defend Michael up here on top. Then we'll, I think we should add like a couple pictures of him. So like a picture of Mike, and then we should have, you know, something describing the case. So case description. And then maybe to finish it off, we'll have some tabs that people can pull to get some more information. So we'll have like the website for the petition on there. And maybe we'll also have some information, an information page that has some more information on Michael himself.
We're making our posters to put outside of AVF or American Veterans Federation sites. And also we're going to put one of these flyers at Crystal Caves in Auburn.
Yeah.
Pictures are finally completely done.
Yes.
We got the brand new summary on there. You can read. We got the tabs. And we got a picture of First Lieutenant Behenna. Hey, what do you have in your hand there?
I have the flyers, which we just printed out. There's two per page, and we got 175 of them. So we're going to cut these up and go start handing them out.
All right. Sounds good.
So we're at school. We printed out some more flyers, which Dan is cutting up right now. And we also have a poster here at school that we are going to be hanging up today. All right.
So Brian, what have you been up to the past couple of days?
I mean, the first couple of days, we made flyers for Lieutenant Behenna. We also made poster boards, and we emailed his family to get in touch with them. And we also spread his awareness out to Facebook and other social medias, such as Twitter. And today we just finished up making the posters. And we also sent a school-wide email to sign a petition. But all in all, it's been a productive couple of days, and we're looking to get these posters out hopefully by today or hopefully by tomorrow.
We're walking over to Veterans Inc. right now. We're going to see if they'll let us hang a poster inside their place. All right. As you can see, we've already started to spread some awareness because this person, D. De Mayo, I think that's how you say it, has already made our flyer their cover photo. All right, we're downtown Boston right now, passing out these flyers for our project, so we're going to get some more people. Thank you.
Good job, Danny. Good boy.
Right?
Yeah.
Thank you.
I cut the end of that one.
Okay. Dance is
good. Alright, here are more people, man. Thank you. Thank you.
See, young people.
I just wish. Thank you, guys. Go.
All right, so we've given out a decent amount of these flyers. We still got a lot more to go, but been pretty successful. A lot of people are taking them, so stay tuned.
rest of your project, but a soldier is an unfair trial. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, fireman. At least you can do. You're a soldier out there fighting for you.
Thank you so much.
Got it.
Yeah, we're good. Yeah, we'll make it three in a row. We'll keep going. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
No doubt. No doubt. No doubt.
Excuse me, miss. I'll give you a flyers for our senior project about a soldier who's in an unfair trial. He's out there fighting.
Oh, damn.
Can I give you one? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
He's out there fighting for us. All you can do is just read that information. Thank you very much.
Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, you're taping?
Yeah, keep going.
All right. Well, we've gone through quite a few. You can see we're down to about this. Robbie's got those right now. So we've put out probably at least 400 flyers just in the city of Boston. So the word will get out pretty fast about this. So
yes.
Defend Michael.
Defend Michael. Thank you.
Alright, can I give you a flyer for a senior project?
Thank you. Thank you. Alright, so we just finished handing out, we probably handed out, I'd say, a good four or five hundred flyers around Boston, which is pretty good. We got a lot of good feedback from people.
My name is Harry Radel, grandfather of Daniel Radel. I am a combat veteran of the Korean and Vietnam War. I retired from the U.S. Army July 31st, 1971, after 23.5 years of service. During the last 9 years of my service, I was with the Special Forces Green Beret outfits. My last assignment was Sergeant Major of the Special Forces School at Fort Bragg, North Carolina. I believe in the military justice system. However, in the case of First Lieutenant Michael Behenna, I believe that he is entitled to another trial. I want to commend Daniel and his friends on taking on this project to ensure that justice is indeed served. I am very proud of the young men for their outstanding devotion and commitment to this cause. God bless America. Thank you very much.
It is a request of the Behenna family on the website that we send letters to First Lieutenant Behenna. So that's what we're going to be doing today.
I'm writing a letter to Lieutenant Mike Behenna, to letting him know that a lot of people are fighting for him and to stay strong and that we're doing the best we can to help get him out.
We're mailing our letters to First Lieutenant Behenna.
I'm just trying to be a father, raise a daughter and a son, be a lover to their mother.
Defend Michael.
Defend Michael.
Defend Michael.
Defend Michael.
Defend Michael.
Defend Michael.
I think that the government should be defending Michael Behenna at all costs.
Defend Michael.
Defend Michael, please.
Free Michael Behenna.
Defend Michael.
Defend Michael from Patty Cantrell, Kingston, Oklahoma.
Defend Michael.
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 Defend Michael!
Hi, my name is Shannon Wall. Defend Michael. Defend Michael. Defend Michael.
defend our son, Michael.
This documentary is dedicated to First Lieutenant Michael Behenna. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. God bless America. Right, I'm out here on the front line.